One week after the death of Russian opposition leader Alexei Navalny, and on the eve of the second anniversary of Russia's full-scale invasion of Ukraine, the Biden administration announced its most sweeping sanctions yet. It put more than 500 entities on the sanctions list, targeting everything from shipbuilding to steel to Russia's financial system. It also targeted three prison officials that the administration says were involved in the death of Navalny. These sanctions are important in a practical and also symbolic sense, but administration officials themselves say that they are not enough to stop Russia, only to slow it down. The U.S. does have other options. The most important thing it can do is release $60 billion in aid that is currently being held up by Republicans in Congress. Because at the end of the day, it is Ukraine fighting on the front lines, both for the independence of its own country, but also against a Russia that is increasingly violent and antagonistic.